rumor would be correct about the new music coming out. The other rumor about it being different than anything I've ever done is also true. There's gonna be a whole different vibe to the album from start to finish. How it starts isn't exactly gonna be how it finishes in subject-wise and sound-wise and location of the production. It's called Back in Boots, My Journey. And it's going to be about my entire journey through music. I started professionally singing when I was 12 years old. And then one of the first major professional things I did was on the West Coast. So it's going to start with that journey on the West Coast. Some of the songs are going to be produced in California. And then we're going to make our way to Nashville because that's the second place that I went to truly make country music. And then part of it is going to represent my home. And it's going to be produced in Virginia, where I was born and raised. And Virginia is kind of where I got my start with Radio Disney. I auditioned for a Radio Disney group when I was 12 years old, and that's where we opened for tens of thousands of people. And it was such a good jump start to realizing, okay, this dream is feasible, and this is really what I want to do. What is the end game for me as an independent artist? Like, do I want to be signed? Have I ever tried to be signed? The easy answer, short answer, is no. I've never actually tried to get signed to a label other than one that I've created. I've never showcased in front of labels. I've never really wanted to, because I always wanted to be able to control the music that I put out and the way I looked, how I dressed, what I wrote about, what I didn't sing about, or what I did sing about. I've always liked that to be under my control because I'm a very stubborn person, but I also have things that mean a lot to me, and I would be lying to people and I'd be lying to the fans and the music listeners if I sung about things that weren't me. So I always wanted to kind of establish my own thing before I ever presented myself to a label. Would I be opposed to being signed by a major label? No, not at all. But I would love to continue to have that creative control because I wouldn't want to sing about anything that does not represent who I am. Yes, there's so many comments on, I've been doing a lot of TikTok lives lately and on Facebook and on Instagram saying, you need to go audition for American Idol or The Voice. Newsflash, I've auditioned for both. And they've said no. I auditioned for American Idol in 2013. I made it through three producer rounds. Yeah, three producer rounds. I made it in front of the judges. They said they didn't like my song choice. I auditioned for The Voice like three or four different times. And never made it past the first audition. And same thing with American Idol more recently. I did a video audition, went through to a second round of video auditions, and they were like, we seen better talent. And I was like, okay, well, that's all good. Turned down a lot of other people that I like. I'm in good company, okay? I have cut back my shows this year a bit because I wanna focus on creating. And that's what I feel like I was born to do. I was born to create and write music and create content for people. And we had so many shows last year, we were so blessed. But because I'm not signed to a major label, everything is in-house. I'm doing all the production behind the scenes, whether it's the tracks on stage, the set list, the practice, the rehearsals. And a lot of our shows were 3-hour shows last year. It just took so much time that I maybe wrote two or three songs in an entire year because my time was so focused on shows and not on creating music, which is what I absolutely loved and why I wanted to start this in the first place, was to create music because I loved songwriting. So cut back on shows a little bit, not a lot. I mean, we're still doing a good amount of shows and we're still booking for this year. But I really wanted to focus on being creative and writing new music, recording new music, music videos, photo shoots, just getting that out to people because there are big gaps between my releases. The last time I released a full EP was in 2020, and I've grown a lot as an artist, as a songwriter, and as a singer since then, and there's new things I wanna say. There's gonna be 10 to 12 songs on the album, and like I said, it's all gonna kinda carry through my journey, and there might be a couple extra bonus nuggets at the end that are just like acoustic, personal songs that I've written that people have commented online that they wanna hear. Recorded, and I haven't done it yet, and it's just gonna kind of be a very singer songwritery like roots vibe. I would like the TikTok phenom a whole lot more if I was one. Listen, okay, so the struggle is real for independent artists out there because One, now there are so many independent artists all across the board on TikTok, on Instagram, on Facebook, on YouTube, and they're going viral. And this is so great. You know, there's a whole new chapter of open doors for independent musicians. But at the same time, it's like, there's so many avenues, you have to try to figure out which one fits you best. And I love TikTok. I love how it introduces brand new people to you like every single day. I wish, you know, you rack your brains out as an independent artist, like, okay, how can I go viral? How can this one song hit? How can more people discover it? And there is no like magic way to it. And it's like this never ending browser just loading and circling in your brain, and you just cannot like escape it, and it bogs down all the memory. Anyways, TikTok's great. TikTok craze is great. The online internet thing is good. I'm just, you know, struggling. Like, you guys, share my videos, please. I would love to be viral. Be a lot better than the viral thing that we went through the last 3 years. Get you some Celeste 19. It's healthy for your soul. Geez. I have been told I was lame a few times. Yes. Biggest misconception about me is that I'm happy and smiling all the time. So not true. I'm also in sweatpants and a messy bun 90% of the time because I'm just not about the glam life. But anyways, I'm in sweatpants right now. Yes! So, biggest misconception about me is that I'm always smiling and that life is great like 100% of the time. Because that's how I appear on social media. You know, I am not one to play victim or put that out there because I don't like staying in that place myself. I am always like, okay, this happened, it sucked. How can I like find good out of it? How can I like move on? How can I turn this as an experience to learn and grow from it? So I'm not gonna post on social media when I'm sad and upset, but I will share some songs that I've written in those times. And if you listen to some of my sad songs, you'll notice that at the end, there's like always a positive turn in some way. I have a new song called Prison that's gonna be on my album that's coming out later this year. And it's dark. And I wrote it when I was in a really dark place. But the last chorus talks about climbing out of that hole, climbing out of that prison and finally escaping from the prison. And when my mom heard it the first time, she started crying because she had no idea that I ever felt that way because I internalize everything. So, misconception, I'm happy and like always cheery. Not necessarily, but do I have a positive outlook on life? Yes. Do I see the glasses half full all the time? Yes. Even with other people when maybe I shouldn't? Yes. But I'm the kind of person that you could be burning my hand. I'd be like, it's all good. Ciao. Have I ever been dumped? You call breaking up with someone through email when you're 14 and 16 dumped, then sure. Other than that, no, I've never been dumped. As an indie artist, I want to be proud of the work that I'm doing. I would love if it charted on Billboard. That would be like, top goals for me. I would just love for people to hear it and relate to it and connect to it and change lives with it. Maybe I've been through a similar situation as somebody else, and maybe they hear a song and it holds their hand through a situation. I mean, I want to be positive in the world. In a sea of negativity now and a sea of like negative songs out there, which don't get me wrong, I like crying to songs too. I want to be the one that you go to when you want to turn that mood around. I want to be the happy songs. I want to be the, okay, I feel this, but you know, I'm stronger than that. I can move on from this point. I want to be those songs, the ones that that really help move me through a tough spot. And that's what I would love more than anything with this new album. The first single is being released 2 weeks prior to CMA Fest. Friday, May 26th, it is a dance remix of Dirt Road Dancing, and we're also releasing a music video the following Friday, June 1st or 2nd, whatever the Friday date is. Anyways, I'll probably put it on the screen down here because I'm an indie artist and I edit my own videos. It's gonna be great and I'm so excited. It has been way too long since I've done a music video. This one's gonna be like 90s and early 2000s pop meets country, and it's gonna be a whole vibe. We're going into 2023, summer 2023, strong pop country 90s fun vibes. That's why I'm in the hot pink and white. Britney Spears, Rocky Balboa. I know that was in the 90s, but this is my Rocky-sized year. This is my golden year. I love Sly Stallone. I've seen all of his movies in like the past month too. It's not like I've spent my whole life on Sly. I just, you know, am obsessed now. And my future husband, if I ever have one, is gonna be Cobra, Sly Stallone, like that whole thing, situation. Yep. Manifesting, God, send me that, please. So y'all, I can't wait for you guys to hear this new album. I want you to go to my Spotify, click the follow button, so you'll be the first to be notified when my new album and releases and singles, because there's gonna be a few singles leading up to the album, are released. You'll be the first to be notified when they come out. Same thing on Apple Music or Pandora or wherever you listen to your music. Amazon, let me give you guys a little preview of the intro of the Dirt Road Dancing remix here. You ready?
Come on, turn it up.